Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be answering a question about placing text in SketchUp. All right, so on SketchUp, the subreddit here, there is a question that basically asks about the amount of text. There's a large amount of text, and they're trying, I think, to use leaders to point out some art. This is about a paragraph of text and not just a little note. I guess they want to see it in one view, and then when they go out, when they scroll out, because the text in leader is dynamic, the text stays the same even though your image shrinks. So they're trying to figure out what's going on here. I also just want to add really quickly that this video tutorial is going to be focused on adding leader text in SketchUp. And in the description down below, I'll link some videos talking about other types of text in SketchUp in case that's what you're looking for, because I know this can be kind of confusing because there's multiple different texts in SketchUp. So if you're looking for one of those, check out the description below. So what I've done here is I was trying to think of a cool way that this might be something that you would use. And so I was thinking about like school science fair projects. And I always think of volcanoes when I think of science fair projects. So I imported this volcano, and I have a block of text off to the right side of my screen from Wikipedia. I wouldn't recommend if you're doing a science project, you just copy and paste from Wikipedia. But that's what I'm going to do here just to save some time. So you see this here. And then to put in a leader, you just select this text. And you would just select here. By default, it's going to give the name of or the definition of the object. That's why this says tropical island terrain. But if I come over to Wikipedia, I'm just gonna copy the first, there's like a line and then a whole paragraph. When I click on this and hit Control V, you can see all that text comes over. But when I exit out, it's all blurry and gross. So we actually can't do that. So what you need to do is sort of come through this and do it really slowly. If I do it like a sentence at a time, and then you sort of want to match it up. It's not going to put in line breaks for you. Unfortunately, you can't choose like a width of window and then it'll make all the text go down. So you have to do that by yourself. So at certain intervals, you'll want to just press enter to make a new line. So we're just going to do that here. So I have that. And then when I get to this new paragraph, so that's the first line, if I want to put like a space in between this, if I hit enter again, it's going to exit out of the edit. So you need to hit enter, hit Control V to paste, and then you can hit enter again to get that space. Do something like this. Just trying to line up where everything goes. So let's say this is, let's put in just one more piece of text. Just one more line. Okay, so let's say we want this to be a little bit smaller. So if I click on it and I have my default tray open, there's entity info will show me some info about the text that I have selected. So if I go to change font, I can change the size here. If you change it to 8, that looks too tiny. Let's try 10. This looks okay. Let's zoom out a little bit. Maybe zoom in. So this seems good to me, and you can always move it if you need to. So just hit M there to move that text. Bring it in a little bit. So this is like a cool little call out. Let me actually delete these. Pretend like these weren't here. So let's get our view set up how we want. And then in your default tray as well, you'll see these scenes. You just wanna hit Add Scene. What that's going to do is it's going to put a little tab up here, and you just want to make sure that the settings that are saved, make sure that you want to make sure for this in particular, hidden geometry is selected. So let's say we like the way this text looks, but we want to keep this text in a different view or something like that. We want to create a new scene, and what I'm going to do here is actually come into this text. I'm going to, it's already all selected, so I'm going to hit Control C. It's going to copy all that text just so I have it on my clipboard. Make a new scene here. So we have a scene two. And let's say we want like a top-down view, right? It actually looks kind of weird. If we zoom out, let's say we want a zoomed out version, right? And let's say this text is too big. Unfortunately, this text is going to stay the same size on our screen no matter what. So what we're going to do for scene two is hide it and make a new leader. So we're going to just select this text option. And we can see here we have ginormous text, so I'm going to change it to 8. This looks way better. So I'm going to just update my scene 2. Go back to scene 1, and you'll see that text that I just put in there is in there. So we need to turn that off. So I'm going to select the text I just put in. I can tell that that's the text that I put in because it's smaller than the other text. So just right-click this. Go to hide, and then you need to make sure that you also update your scene. And then just to show you quickly, I'm going to turn off scene transitions, animation, disable scene transitions. That way it doesn't show the little animation between the two. And you can see just really quickly, and maybe I want this to be a little bit bigger, let's say 9. And that's how you can get different text. Now, if I go to view and hit show hidden, you can see that there's that other text is still in here. It's just hidden from the view. Just something to be aware of as you're going through this is that other text is still there. It's just hidden. So it's not going to dynamically link or anything when you change one of these texts. It's not going to update in the other. So make sure your text is finalized when you go to do this. So hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.